Given a behavior spec for a protocol, say TCP/IP, can a stack be synthesized as a composition of the ensemble microprotocols? Given 60 microprotocols in the ensemble suite, there are way too many combinations for a brute force approach. Instead, in the ensemble approach, the user heuristic algorithm for synthesizing the stack given the desired behavioral spec and designer's knowledge of the microprotocols. The result is a protocol stack which is functional but not optimized for performance. Of course, as operating system designers, we're always worried about performance, and we naturally have to think about how to optimize the protocol stack so that it is not only functional, but it also performant. In particular, the fact that we've assembled this protocol stack like Lego blocks, putting together all these microprotocols, leads to layering, and layering leads to inefficiencies. Now, this is where the analogy to VLSI component-based design breaks down. And the reason is because in VLSI component-based design, even though we are building a complex chip like a CPU by putting together components, the components just fit together very nicely. There is no inefficiency in going between these components. But in software components, unfortunately, they have interfaces. And interfaces usually mean that there is well-defined boundaries between these components. And so to cross the component boundary, you may have to copy parameters, adhere to interface specifications of the components, and so on. All of those things leads to inefficiencies. And this is where the VLSI component-based design idea breaks down a little bit when we just put together the components of software in order to build the large-scale system. So we have to do the extra work that is needed in order to optimize the component-based design so that it can perform well. Fortunately, there are several sources of optimization that are possible. For instance, I mentioned that OCaml has implicit garbage collection. Now, it is good that it has implicit garbage collection as a fallback, but maybe we don't want to use it all the time and we want to be explicit about how we manage our own memory that can be more efficient. That is a source of optimization. I mentioned that OCaml has ability for doing marshalling and unmarshalling of arguments to go across layers, which is also a very good thing to do in order to have a component-based design. But when we're going across layers, these things can add overheads, and this is another source of optimization that is possible by avoiding these marshalling and unmarshalling across the layers by collapsing the layers. Another opportunity that exists, especially in networking systems, is the fact that there is going to be communication and computation. If you think about the TCP/IP protocol, it has to necessarily buffer the packets that it's sending out, because if the packets are lost for some reason, it may have to retransmit it. This is again a situation where we can overlap this buffering, which is computation on the node that is sending the packet, with the actual transmission. So we can overlap that. That's another opportunity for optimization. Another opportunity is compressing the header, especially when we have these layering. At every layer, it might add a new header specific to that layer, and that may have common fields, for instance, size of the packet or checksum for the packet and so on. Those are common things that you can eliminate when we are going across these layers, so the header compression is another possibility for optimization. Another thing that we always have to worry about is making sure that the code that we execute fits in the caches. And this has been something that we've talked about all along when we talked about single node systems to parallel systems, that locality enhancement, making sure that the working set of whatever code that is executing on a processor fits in the cache, is very important. So this again is an opportunity by identifying common code path across the different layers of the protocol stack and co-locating that common code path across the layers in order to make sure that we can enhance locality for processing is another source of optimization that is possible. This is all good, so there are lots of opportunities for optimization, but do it by hand, manually, that's tedious. So how do we automate the process of optimization so that we don't have to do it manually?